to our sector and to the nation. The pandemic has undeniably been devastating for the tourism sector, resulting in many businesses not being able to keep their doors open or battling to survive as their revenue and sales continue to shrink, leading to forced staff reductions or retrenchments. As we pick up not from where we have left, but rather in a new environment, we are putting together the pieces of a new path towards recovery as many people in our sector return to work to provide for their families following months of hardship as we traverse through one of the most difficult periods in the history of our country and indeed the world. Our road to recovery as a sector has begun. We'll, in the coming weeks, consolidate inputs received on the tourism recovery strategy before we submit our plan to Cabinet. Our intention as the department is to start as soon as possible working together with our sector with the implementation of the recovery plan. We are mindful that this is critical as tourism is one of the pillars of the broader South African economic recovery and growth. We are appreciative of the role played by various organizations in all subsectors, small businesses in townships, rural communities, the women in tourism, the youth in tourism, and other individuals who have reached out to make submissions as we move towards rebuilding of our sector. Heightened cooperation and partnerships amongst all sector players are essential as we implement our response plan and lay a foundation for a healthier, more resilient, and competitive future. Our analysis of the global trend is that today and tomorrow's traveler is looking for a destination that offers diversity. They will be still cautious to move from one country to the other during their tours, and therefore are looking for a country that offers more experiences. South Africa, as a destination, offers variety and diversity in terms of attractions, products, and activities with world-class experiences, giving us competitive and comparative advantage amongst other destinations for this new global traveler. We will continue to do this analysis and rebuild our marketing proposition of Destination South Africa. This as we move one step at a time. We are highly encouraged by the interest we are seeing from both domestic and international investors looking for opportunities in the tourism sector. This gives hope that the supply side of tourism sector will not only recover but have a potential to surpass where we were as a sector prior to the pandemic. Our responsibility is to ensure that as we recover and grow, we bring along the previously disadvantaged groups. Therefore, ensuring inclusivity, transformation, and sustainability of our tourism sector. We will use our Tourism Equity Fund as a mechanism to support this transformation imperative in the sector. Ladies and gentlemen, the announcement by President Ramaphosa to move to Alert Level 2 of the COVID-19 risk-adjusted strategy as from Tuesday, 18th August 2020, marked a significant leap and milestone for the tourism sector. The move will reignite business activities, save jobs, and the many livelihoods that facing difficulties during this pandemic. We therefore welcome the decision by Cabinet to permit tourism services for the categories as stated in the gazetted regulations. We have developed directions for the tourism sector to provide further clarity on the existing regulations issued to limit the spread of the virus, and in a manner that they can be adaptable in a rapidly changing context. As we open up the sector, we are therefore confident that measures have been put in place to protect employees, suppliers, tourists, and all those who are involved with the sector. As government, we remain committed to work in a coordinated manner to ensure recovery that meets the national development objectives. Our main goal is to ensure that no tourism facility becomes a source of the spread of the pandemic. And we are encouraged that since the beginning of the opening and bringing back the activities in the tourism sector, we are doing well and we've not seen us being a source of the spread. I want to say to the sector and all those who participate and who are supporting the tourism industry that let us keep this up. Let us keep this trend to become the norm in the tourism sector. And also, let us hold one another accountable against this commitment for the sake of our people and the country and the industry. I will now highlight the areas that have been opened up at under level 2 of risk-adjusted strategy. Under accommodation, the requirements announced under level 3 remains, meaning all those issues that we've raised about record-keeping, social distancing, and ensuring that we wear the mask where necessary, where expected, in terms of our facilities remain. And what we are adding into this direction is that, because previously we were only allowing the intra-provincial travelers for leisure, now we are saying accommodation are allowed to accommodate any South African within those facilities. But we also emphasize that in our direction, within their breakfast areas, within their reception area, in order to ensure that there is a safe distance, the social distancing requirement, they need to ensure that the 50% occupancy in terms of floor space is maintained. Under restaurants, again, here we are saying the announcements that have been made in terms of the directions under level 3 remain. In addition to this is the on-site consumption of alcohol, which is permitted for licensed restaurants and bars. I need to indicate, because we do have bars within our hotels, and if they do operate, we want to emphasize that all of our facilities must adhere to the curfew at 10 p.m. So curfew starts at 10 p.m. We request South Africans that you are not going to be found on the streets because you come from the restaurants at 10 p.m. Because I can assure you, Minister Cele will be on the streets waiting for you. So we want to appeal, as you support the sector, please ensure that the curfew time applies to all the restaurants, to all those who are providing services in terms of our facilities and our sector. Having visited restaurants myself in the past few weeks, I'm encouraged to see a lot of innovation from the subsector, such as where you are able to scan using your phone a barcode and you are able to see the menu on your hands. This actually assists for many of us to be able to enjoy our meals without having to worry that the menu I'm holding has been in another person's hand. So I want to continuously encourage this innovation in our sector as part of becoming and living with the new normal. Places of attractions are now opened. This includes, but not limited to, theme parks, amusement parks, water parks, family entertainment centers, zoos, aquariums, science centers, nature and game reserves, national parks, and other entertainment and cultural activities. Tourism attractions must ensure social distancing, for example, by marking on the floors so that tourists or visitors are able to maintain that social distance by knowing exactly where to stand as they do their excursions. We further encourage online booking where possible to allow the management of the numbers in the facilities. We also request the tourist attraction facilities to ensure that tourists and tour guides wear their masks and sanitize regularly. So this is not no exemption. As they do the visits, they must always wear their masks. Provide sanitation where attractions have touch screens and touch buttons. For all activities such as water, quad bikes, hot air balloon, etc., we need to ensure that at all times, every time after use, the equipments and those facilities are being sanitized so that we can make sure that we do not become a source of transmission. The self-drives at game farms, the directions remains the same as per level 3. So no addition, no changes in this area. On guided tours, tour guides to ensure social distancing. For example, you'd find that tour guides are doing tours in the hop-in, hop-off buses. They need to make sure that within those buses or within their cars, the seats are marked properly so that we can ensure, say, social distancing. Or where it's standing areas in the attractions or within the doing the tours, they must make sure that there is a marking in terms of allowing social distancing. They must ensure that the people who are on the tours and together themselves are tour guides wear the masks and sanitize regularly. Tour guides are requested to keep records in terms of the people that they are taking on tours, and they must make this available to the authorities that are relevant whenever necessary or whenever they are required. Now, moving to weddings and function venues, want to emphasize that as we welcome this area as well in terms of activities, want to emphasize that the maximum requirement number in terms of the people who attend must comply with the gatherings numbers in terms of 50 people. The second issue is that also there must be an emphasis on social distancing. We must ensure that there's sanitizing in terms of the directions. We are saying that make sure that there's sanitizing, the screening, there's wearing of masks at all times. But also what we want to emphasize, like we've done with our accommodations, we've done with our restaurants, no buffets should be allowed. So these are some of the activities I've flagged in terms of the areas, but as we go into the directions, I've highlighted the areas that are coming back in terms of all our attractions, in terms of all the venues that we have. A number of those that I've not highlighted is because they've been allowed already in level 3 and we've issued those directions. So we've gone just to add those that have been missing and that needed clarity for us to be able to clarify. I will be, as the minister, embarking on site visits as part of leading from the front as we encourage South Africans to not only support the tourism sector to preserve the businesses and the jobs, but also to enjoy their beautiful country after months of being in their homes. We request you to do this responsibly and comply with all the protocols. As we travel again, we must travel safely. We will invite the media to join us for the launch of the Tourism Month as part of our domestic tourism campaign. Many of you would note that as tourism, we celebrate Tourism Month in September, and we will have quite a number of activities as we bring back our domestic tourism and tourism activities to life in this level 2. Ladies and gentlemen, as I conclude, COVID-19 surely impacted on our operations, but certainly not our sense of hospitality. The sector stands ready to host you wherever and whether it is whether it is a visit to the local botanical garden, to a restaurant, or an overnight trip to another province. Go and enjoy yourself and don't forget to share your experiences as we strive for excellence, resilience, and competitiveness. And as I say, we travel again, but let's travel safely. Nakensa.